Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video we will learn how to create a monthly expense management sheet. We will also cover income in this, but our main focus will be on expenses side. So without wasting any time, let's start. As we already have this sheet open, so we will rename it as master sheet, or you can name it as report. So here we will have category, and then we will have amount, and title will be monthly expense management sheet. And we'll make some space for category and also for amount. So everyone will have more or less same things as categories, like meals, rent, and then entertainment, utilities, shopping, insurance, travel, grocery, some savings. This is not actually an expense, but it's better to treat it as expense because one should always have some savings around their expenses. And then some miscellaneous expenses. So normally I would even have these type of expenses. So let's fix this as capital. And for amount, we will use a formula that will be coming from our next sheet. So I will do it later. And also in the bottom, we will have income. And then after one line, we will have cash flow. So it can be positive and negative as well. And negative will be shown in minus or in brackets. So let's create our next sheet. From here, we'll name it as expenses, or you can call it inflow and outflow. And for title, I will type inflow and outflow. And here we will have date, then description. Then this will be called category. And then we will have deposits. This will show income, and then withdraw or withdrawals. So this will be for expenses. So anything going out of your cash will be in withdrawals, and anything coming into your cash or bank, it will be in deposits. So let's do some quick formatting. I will select these all five sales, and then from format as sales, I will select this one. From here, I will see my table has headers. So I'll select this and then press OK. So now you can see the formatting. And now I will press Alt-D-FF to remove these filters. And here we will have our data. Let's say we had our first transaction on 1st January 2023. And description was Duke Energy. And I will leave category for now. And the amount was 36 as withdrawal. And the next transaction we have is on same date. So I will copy this date and paste it here. And the description was T-Mobile. And I will leave the category now. And the amount was $48. So now let's fix our category. So for category, we will use conditional formatting. So I will select this sale, and by pressing Alt Shift down, I will select this table. And now I will go into data. And from here, I will select this data validation. And we'll select this data validation again. And from here, I will select list. And then for source, I will select this. And it will ask to select data range. So by pressing Control Page Up, I will go into our master sheet. And then I will select our sales from here, where we have our categories. So from meals till income. And then I will press Enter. And enter again. So now you will see, so when I will select any sale, it will show a drop down here. So when I will click here, it will have all the options as category. So Duke Energy is related to utilities, so I will select utilities. And for T-Mobile, this is also utilities, so I will select utilities. Then here, let's say we received our income, and it was salary in our case, which was received on 4th of January, and it was salary. And then from here, we will select income as category, and it was around 5,000. Let me fill some data here so we can move ahead quickly. As you can see, we have this dummy data. Let's fix this date issue. And now you can see we have expenses around all the categories. And as we have used data validation, So you can only select category from this list, nothing else. And let's format this as well. So I will click here, and from home I will select format painter and then paste it here. And then by pressing shift right 4 times, I will select all these cells and press merge and center, and then increase the font size. Now let's move to our master sheet, and then we'll have formatting here as well. So I will select till here, then from format as table, I will select this same format and we'll check mark this box, and then okay, and I will press Alt+DFF, and now I will copy the same format by pressing format painter and paste it here, and then I will merge these both cells by pressing Alt+HM and enter. And I will also copy this formatting with same way, click here and then paste it here, and then I will select this cell and paste it here as well. So I will make these as bold, and also if you want you can bold these categories as well. And for amount we will use a formula which is sum if, so it's equals to sum if. So we will use this formula, sum if, because we have only one condition here. Then tab, so it's asking to select range, so we have our range in expense sheet. So by pressing control page down we will go there, and I will select this range from categories. So I will select from here till the end. As you can see, it has selected that table and this category line, and then I will press comma, so it's asking for the condition. So here we want amount for meals, so I will select meals, then comma. Now it's asking for sum range, so from where to take this amount. So we'll again go in the expense sheet, and now we will select this withdrawal line, so from here till the end, and enter. So now you can see we have got all the expenses here. Let's add one more line here by pressing shift space. I'll select this, and then control shift plus, so we'll have this line, and then I'll press total. You can see this. Then here I will press Alt equals to, so it will sum up everything in this line. So let's make it bold. And for income we will use same formula, but here we will select deposit is sum range, so equals to sum if, then tab, then for range we will select same category, and then comma. For income we will select income as criteria and comma. And now for sum range we will select this line which is deposit, and enter. As you can see, we have got income from expense sheet. And for inflow and outflow we will use a basic formula which is equals to income minus expenses. So we have this total of our expenses, and enter. So you can see we have positive cash flow of $127. So if you want to see this all in dollars, so you'll select this till here, and from here we'll press here, so it will give it a dollar sign, and you can remove decimals from here, so you can see everything in dollars. And now even after doing this all, now let's do some modification in our expenses and income. So expenses, and let's say now I will add one more income, so I'll paste it here. Let's say interest income, and I will select income as category. Let's say I received $40 as income, which will be in deposits, and I will go in master sheet. You can see it's showing 5040. So now it has also included that interest income in this, and now we have 167 as positive. And let's go into expenses, and let's say I saved everything which was left, so savings. So I will select saving here as well, and I will type 167 and enter. So let's check master sheet, and you can see zero, because we have saved that amount here in savings. And before it was 400, and now it's 567. And now let's fix this, and let's say now I want to see all these expenses in the form of charts. So I will select this data from here till the end, and then we'll go into insert, then from here I will select this pie chart, and I will select this one, and from here I'll change the design. This one is fine, I think, but let's choose this one, and let's increase the size of this chart, and also let's zoom this in. and this one. So now you can see this all. So rent is 50% of the expenses because it's 2500 out of 5040. So now if we change anything in the expense sheet, this master sheet along with this chart will also get updated. So let's try. So here, let's change this saving to 500 and let's change category as grocery. And let's check master sheet now. So you can see everything has changed. So before it was 50%, but now it's 47, and our cash flow is negative because we have spent more than our income. And before grocery was not this much, and now it has increased. So even if I increase it further by making it 1000, so you will see a major change here. It's 19%. And I hope this video was helpful. You can download this sheet from the link below, but I will encourage you to create it yourself. And I will be creating an advanced version of this sheet in future, where you will have option to manage all yearly expenses, but you will have a filter from which you can filter your data. Let's say in a year you want to see data for a particular month, so you will have option to select our data range. So you can select a monthly data, quarterly or half yearly, so you can select any range you want. So stay tuned for that. You guys can support me on Patreon and buy me a coffee from the link below. And if you want me to create a customized sheet for you, you can reach out to me from the link below. And if this video was helpful, please hit that like button, comment down if you have any question, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe.